as Miovision, the main mobility challenges for cities are around trying to do too much out of the gate. We know that mobility comes in all shapes and sizes, including buses, scooters, walkers, runners, and cyclists. And we need to address and support municipalities and cities and agencies to help deliver an integrated mobility plan, but do it in a way that allows them to move all those different types of people around their cities safer, more efficiently, and with more success. In the case of Miovision, we collect video and we collect data of how people move within a city. With technology, the way that we see how Miovision can help is that, yes, we can set up a partnership for just traffic. The benefits can also support the sustainability and green teams within your department. It can support your smart city initiatives. It can support your police, fire, and ambulance department. It can support your transit and bus services. One specific example that I'd love to share is the police department in Kyle, Texas. They adopted our Miovision Opticom solution to help their emergency vehicles move to and from accidents more efficiently and restore confidence in their police and emergency responders that driving to emergencies would allow them to travel in that corridor safer. They implemented our technology. They reduced the accidents down to zero, that police and fire and ambulances weren't getting into accidents on the way to accidents. As well, it increased the confidence of those emergency vehicle responders to move quickly and deliberately through that corridor without having to worry about a traffic light or somebody moving through a traffic corridor that the stop, the red light has been preemptively stopped, allowing that individual or the emergency responder to get to where they need to go safely and more effectively. In addition to that, we partnered with the City of Peterborough to implement our TrafOp and adaptive solution at roughly 70 intersections. And what they saw from that data was not only traffic benefit and allowing them to move cars more efficiently, but they noticed that it reduced the equivalent of 70 tons of greenhouse gases per intersection per year. Now what that allows them to do is think differently about how they're actually leveraging, capturing, and tracking their own accountability to the environment and to carbon in this case, so that they can not only better their traffic and their flow within their city, but as an additional outcome, make a meaningful impact on reducing idling and congestion and greenhouse gases due to cars sitting idle at intersections waiting to get moving. So those things become ways that we can kind of work together with a city that's motivated to not only benefit from, say, a traffic outcome, but also a sustainability or green outcome that will allow them to kind of connect both of those departments and allow both of them to benefit from an integrated offering from Miovision. Well, data, when you're using it, is very powerful, but you have to be really mindful of the community's perception of what you're doing with that information. But if the outcome is we want to collect data that helps people move to and from safer, we want to reduce bike accidents, or we want to reduce collisions on the road, and we want to allow ambulance to move to and from corridors faster and safer, then capturing an amount of data that's commensurate with solving that problem is okay, as long as you do it the right way. And in our case, we house the data in a fortified AWS mainframe here in the United States. And that allows us to make sure that that data is being collected purposefully with intention to benefit the community. Once we actually do the work of working together cross-functionally, both from Miovision as well as from the various cross-functional members of a city or state that might be motivated to make a profound change, that's when this type of project gets more accelerated and more teams get excited about how they could all benefit from a single platform that allows them each individually at a functional level to benefit from making a real profound change in their communities. So the best practice is find a friend or phone a friend and make sure that they can really understand how the information will be moving and kind of set the governance of how that can happen early so that they can really make sure that they're telling a really great story when it goes up the chain to the various levels of government for approval.